Hi, it's Tom again. This lesson is about fruits. One of the things that I want to make sure that you take away is the relationship between the parts of a fruit and how they trace back to particular tissues in the flower. So to start with, we're going to take a look at a tomato, and initially at a drawing of a tomato flower because I don't have one this time of year that I can show you. But if you'll bear with me, I put a cartoon of a tomato flower up on the board and we can compare, we can review some of the structures. So you know down here the stalk that the flower is on is called the peduncle. And then at the base of the flower is the receptacle. And now for the four whorls that make up the flower. The first whorl is the calyx whorl, and so on that you have the green sepals. The next whorl up is the corolla whorl, where you have the petals, and I have those in white here. The anoecium whorl has on it the sepals. The stamens, and the stamens are made up of the anther, where the pollen is produced and released, and a filament, which is a thin stalk. Now, in a tomato, mostly what we see are the anther portion, and right at the base would be a very small filament. And I've got the anthers here in yellow. So these are the, so the anthers are showing, but we'll call it a stamen, which is anther and filament, and again, it's the anoecium whorl. And then the real focus that I have, though, is the gynoecium, which is made up of a carpel. And you'll recall the carpel has three parts. It has a stigma at the top where the pollen lands and begins to grow. A style here. And the style is the tube through which the pollen tube grows. But the most important part from the standpoint of a fruit is here at the ovary. Because what you'll learn in this lesson is that the fruit is made up of the ripened ovary wall and the seeds inside.